Greetings and welcome to episode 68 of our Let's Play series. It's another week and we're going to continue where we left off. We're going to be working on our refined storage project. And so let's just jump right into it. So here we are back inside. So what I was thinking is we're going to expand upon what we've already done. We've already got the pulverizer here, so we might as well put in a few more machines with a few more crafters on them to expand upon our recipe repertoire. Now one of the problems we had is our Ender Lily cloche is not doing so good. It won't pump the items out, so we're going to have to figure that out at some point too. Maybe not today, but in the future. So what I was thinking here is let's jump right into thermal. One of our main used parts. I would actually like to take these machines here, not the machines themselves. I want to leave these machines here, but have a wall in here with these machines on it that this system will use to create everything I need. So at some point, I won't even have to use these anymore. I'll just be able to search in here for the item and craft it. That is the eventual goal. I'm not saying that has to happen right this second, but that is what we would like to happen. So, what I was thinking is let's build this. We already have the gears in there. We already have the reception coil. We already have the machine frame. So, let's expand upon it with bricks. So, we have clay, right? And one of the interesting things about the clay that we have, right, which we put in here is we have the blocks of clay and we have the bits of clay. Now, the bits of clay has plenty of room to grow and expand. Not that it's choosing to or anything. We don't have a lot of it. But I'm thinking that we should take this one and it shouldn't be here. So what I'm going to do is we're going to add it to the constructor over here. Ah, we're not able to. We're going to need another constructor. So let's do that real quick. So we're going to go in here and we're going to click on. And we did not save it as a recipe. That's fine because it won't be a standard recipe. So let's go back into our refined storage. Let's see here. Constructor. Should have all that's required. Oh, almost. So let's see. What are we missing? We're missing some quartz and an improved processor. Let's do this here. Let's make them real quick. And we have our improved processor, and then we could use some enriched quartz, like so. So we should have what it takes now. There we go. So let's add this one into the network, and we totally forgot cables, didn't we? There we go. We'll grab 28 of those, and what we'll do here is we do not have the recipe for cables saved in here either. So let's, ho, always remember, not in the hand. Let's clear this here. And let's do this recipe. And we'll throw this in the system as well. We're gonna be able to expand quite a bit on our stuff here. So this constructor will be around a block like so. So we'll put that. Oh, the destructor is helping us out a little more than it should. There's no way we're going to be able to shift click it on there if we got that destructor in the way. So let's break this for a second. We're getting a lot of achievements here. I thought we already had all the achievements for this, but that's fine. So, let's put a placeholder block in there. We need just something. Let's just use a piece of stone. The destructor will destroy anything. Okay, so what we want to do is we need to add the other constructor. Like so. Make sure that it knows that it's going to be doing the clay. And then we'll put the destructor in place, like so, and it will destroy anything. Now we need to connect this one up, There we go. Now, it'll just keep doing it. Again, our sounds are muffled from this one, so it'll help out. So it'll break those down, and it should be stacking taking them from here and stacking them over here, which it already is. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take and make some bricks if we don't have some already. And I don't see any. Oh, we have these two right here. I still wanna teach it the recipe. So we're gonna prep it to cook it and make the other one. But again, we're making the recipe here. So let's go at thermal. We have a lot of thermal stuff. So we're gonna want to make this one at thermal. More so. Okay. So we're gonna make our recipe for this one. Throw our two bricks in there. Go up here and we're going to add that in there, just like the other machine. And now let's try this again. Or we could go furnace. So we're gonna make one. Just like that. So everything required, we pretty much had a recipe for already. Oh, we need a crafter to go with that. What am I thinking? We got our five that we made here. Oh, we need to put our... We forgot something. The fortune upgrade. I'm not sure it affects this one, but just in case, we should put it there. So, throw down our crafter. And you'll notice something about the crafter here, right? Aside from this, we're going to go like that. You'll notice that it got power just by being associated to it. I'm not sure that it works being associated to it, but it definitely has power from just contact. So we're gonna need another importer. We can just craft that right up. Just gotta cook up the little processors that go in it. And then it will make it. And there we go. So we'll do the same setup. Looks like all our achievements got reset. Okay, so we got our importer here. Let's set our output to on top. And then let's set our input in the back. So, let's make our first recipe. What should our first recipe be? Let's make it those bricks. Not that we'll use them very often. Let's make it those bricks. Okay. What we're gonna do here is we'll go processed. Then let's see if we can just do the brick real quick. So like so. Man, it even ghost those in there. That's almost cheating. Almost. Okay, so we put that in there and we should be good to go. So now it has the ability to make the bricks. Throw that back in there. So the next thing we want to do is teach it how to do this one. So not a process. But that one. Now we have, whoops, did not mean to uncheck that. Okay, there we go. So another recipe down, another crafter installed. We now have bricks. At some point we're gonna have almost every recipe we're gonna use in this system. So that if I wanna make something all the way up to the jetpack I'm wearing, I have all the recipes, all the machines set up, all of it. So, what is a common thing that we would use to cook? So, the silicone. So let's look at what it takes to make the silicone that we need for the processors, because it's not going to last forever. And then the glass. So, what is the process for making silicone? So, we cook Sirtis quartz. So, we have a two-step process here to make it. So, first step would be we're going to need to grind up Sirtis quartz. So, let's go here and let's type in Sirtis quartz. We have plenty of Sirtis quartz, right? So we're going to type our silicone in here, and we have it right here. So this is going to be the recipe we're going to go for. We're going to make it a process recipe, like so. You'll take the Sirtis quartz dust, and you'll make silicone. And the next one will be how we make this one. So we'll go, and we'll find the one that represents the pulverizer, and we're going to go... not the charged Sirtis quartz, but the regular Sirtis quartz equals Sirtis quartz dust. And we make that one. This is our pulverizer recipe. This is our redstone furnace recipe. So let's put them in place. There you go. And there you go. So now we have the recipes to make those if something asks for it. Now next, the recipe for glass is gonna become important. Eventually we won't have these here. We'll just have glass. So of course, again, we look at our recipe. Let's make some glass. So, recipe. It's gonna say we cook up sand. So we wait for the white sand, or the regular sand, which we have in abundance. And there we go. We make that. So, next step is, should I make the one that represents sand? Well, we get sand from things, but what happens if we run out? Well, we have recipes for that, don't we? We sure do. So what I'm gonna do here is, we have this recipe for making glass. Let's look at the recipe for making sand. We already have one that breaks down this. We won't necessarily use dried sand, but we could use a, let's see if we can find it, a pulverizer recipe for cobblestone, and that'll give us sand. It's pretty simple. Now there are other ones we could use. We could use smooth stone. I think there's even one that uses gravel, but I'm not sure, and I don't really want to use that one. Yeah, there's one that uses gravel, but it's a really low percentage chance. We want to try to have a guarantee here, which is this one right here. So then we go like this, and it'll give us cobblestone, gives us sand, and I'm gonna cut that out of there. It won't let me cut that out of there. Well, we'll have two in the same recipe. No, I don't think that's very good. We'll blank that out. And then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna look up cobblestone and sand. Clear this. Go like that. I always mess that up. I forget. And then sand. Like so. This will do a separate one for gravel, because at a 15% chance, we don't want it to count on that for gravel. So the sand goes there, and the glass goes there. So if it ever runs out of glass, it'll have the ability to continue to make it. Now, let's expand upon that some more here. So what are some of the other things we would use? Well, sometimes we need pulverized materials, like the pulverized obsidian that we used to make there, for, well, the hardened glass and other recipes that require it. So let's continue to expand upon what we had going already. The induction smelter is another machine that we use to cook up items, specifically the harder items to make in thermal expansion. Your lumium, your endurium, and of course our Cingulum. Now the Cingulum we can make. I wonder if we could do a full recipe for Cingulum. And we might be able to. But we're gonna need to work on fluid storage and other stuff like that to get into that. So that will come. We'll get there. But let's see, what else do we randomly need to be able to make for thermal? Because we'll dedicate this to thermal. Well, we make our cables, right? So let's rock those. These cables here transfer 9,000 RF, and it's the main ones we use. They'll work great for the machines, and they'll never overload the machine. They'll never be too little for the machines that we have here. So we need a basic fluid transposer and a redstone flux duct that's empty. But we don't have a fluid setup yet. We're gonna need to make a fluid setup. So let's look into that. We might as well get a little bit into fluids, I guess. So we're here at refined, and we have the basic storage blocks. There should also be basic fluid storage blocks. And what we'll do here is we'll make this one. I think it'll hold 128 buckets, which isn't a lot. In fact, I wonder if we could use, we may end up experimenting here, but an external storage with like these guys. And we're gonna find out, I guess that would be something we could look into right now. So external storage bus, and we need this one, the destruction core. Let's craft it real quick. There we go. Oh, we were missing something else. Oh yeah, the improved processor. So let's do that. We can make one of those fairly quickly as well. There we go. So now we have our external storage bus. I actually wouldn't mind making the recipe for that. We seem to be using it quite often. So it's not a process here. So go like so. We'll throw that in the system. I anticipate we will have crafters crawling all across here with what we need. Okay, so we have our external storage bus, and let's grab some liquid. Let's see if it will work. Oh wait, just grab our wrench. It's much easier if we use our wrench. So, what I want to do here is we need a place to put it here. Let's try right here. And then let's go like that. Let's see if the liquid shows up. I don't know if it will. But it might. I don't see it in there. That was creosote oil. It did not show up. So, lesson learned. Cannot use an external storage with a tank of any kind. We have to have fluid storage. But that's okay. Each block, we can get up to 512. Won't be that bad. But I don't think we'll go for that right off the bat. I think we'll go for the 256 because it's going to require quite a bit here. So, basically what I want to do here is we're going to make all the recipes required to get from point A to point B, start to finish, on these fluid storage blocks. So, we have all that we need to know about the recipe just by clicking on all the components here. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to make several of these 256s. See, I don't know if I should quite go to the 512. Well, why not? I mean, honestly, we have the materials and whatnot, so we should. So process 512. We'll start with the first one, the actual component itself. And we already have this one. And we already have that one. So what we need is this one. So for this one, we need to switch from a process here. go like this. There's the next one. That'll go into a crafter. We have all of these. We don't have the bucket. So we need to do the bucket now. And there's the next one. So we're going to go back. What we're going to do here is go R this one. Now we need to do each of these. Well, we only need to do one of them, but you get the idea. Because you already have the enriched, the quartz enriched iron. So now we need to make these 256 fluid storage parts. Like so. There we go. And then, once we got those, we go to the next one inside there. This one. Oh wait, we just did the 256 storage. So now we need to do the 128 storage. Because we still have all of these made. And then from there, we're going to do... That is the 128. Then we're going to do this one. And it's basic. It requires our glass, the bucket, and silicone. Now, we have all these components down to the bare minimum. So we have the pattern block and all of these. Now, the next thing we could do is, since we said we didn't want to make the 512 yet, we only want to make the 256, we could actually do this process recipe. We'll add it in there, not that we should use it necessarily, but we'll add it in there. So, we have our solderers here that we have set up. So, we have two new solder recipes. And then we have a whole slew of crafting recipes that we gotta make room for. Like so. So now, we can make those fluid storage blocks from scratch, start to finish. So, we might as well make a couple 512s. In fact, we might as well make four of them. And we'll allow the system to go from start to finish. It's gonna have to do everything itself. We are missing silicone. I thought I taught it how to make silicone. Oh, it wants the applied energistic silicone. We made the wrong one. Okay, so let's look it up here. So we got a refined storage here. Our silicone is made from nether quartz. Can we swap out the requirement? Let's see here. We need, I think it's this one. We're going to go back and evaluate this one and see if we can swap it out. Okay, so it shows that the regular silicone, which one requires the other silicone? So this requires silicone, basic quartz. This one doesn't require silicone, neither does this one. So what in the pattern requires silicone? We have one that's require some other component that's requiring silicone. Oh, that's just wood planks. So one of these other ones is requiring silicone. I'm not sure which one it is. Because I don't want to teach you, that's going to consume a ton of nether quartz. Let's see how much we have. Let's make a determination whether we should have both recipes in there or not. Where's our nether quartz at? Here it is. Well, we have 41,000. I guess it's not that big a deal. So let's teach it that recipe, I guess. But I'm not sure which component originally requested it. So let's go through this here. So that's the iron. I wonder if it's this one. The printed silicone. So let's go here, basic processor, silicone. Because we could have accidentally done it this way. Without intention. I mean, it's no big deal if it is. It's just something we gotta switch out. Because we want to stick to one type here. So let's go in here. It's not showing the recipe. Like it did that one time. If I change for process, it should show it, right? Yeah, it is the smaller refined storage silicone. So I think we did swap it out. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, shift clicking with it in your hand empties out the recipe. Okay. So what I want to do here is, now we're going to try it again. So let's see about making our, let's see about making our 512s here. Like I said, we want four. Let's see. Is it requiring? No, it's not. It looks like we found our small error in there and we made adjustments to it, which is great. It requires 34 of those, but it may require 34 of those for something else. Good enough. Start. So let it go to town. It'll take a minute because it's got a lot of processors to cook. Eventually we'll break it up into more solderers so that we can get this done a little bit faster. But that's fine. We'll allow it to work and then we'll find a place to put them. I always find this so weird. It's not outputting them. Even though it's the same as these other ones, it's got the same importer. I don't know. We'll have to figure it out at some point. But for now, it'll be just fine. So as you can see, we're working our way through this here. This is finished with the clay as it comes through. Same with the dimensional shards. We have more and more recipes up here that we're going to need to continue to add to. In fact, we need to add more blocks already. Like so. We're going to need to make more crafters. So our system is growing with each and every upgrade. And so we're at 151 RF per tick, which is the FE. It's pretty good. So with that, I think we're going to call this episode to a close. I thank you guys again for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.